how much more amazing and clean this milk tastes. It just has such a better flavor. Hey y'all, it's Amy from the Harris Homestead, and today I want to chat with y'all just a minute about why our family drinks raw milk. I like to share about our homegrown lifestyle, a lot of our natural living tips, our home renovations, and today I just want to share a little backstory on why we started drinking raw milk, some of the health concerns that some people have, where you can locally find it in your own area. So when I first heard about drinking raw milk, I was very skeptical. I started researching it because we were looking for alternate formula for my son. So he was on breast milk, but we were having to supplement just a little bit with some formula, and he was not reacting well to the formula, and we went through several different kinds. Without knowing much more about commercial formulas, I understand why his body was not reacting to the formula. It's filled with toxins and chemicals and GMO crops and just horrible things if you want to just read the ingredient label. So I had seen an article about making your own homemade formula for your child, and I was like, huh, who makes their own formula? And I began reading a little more. I talked with my husband about it, and we decided that we would go for it. And the main ingredient in the homemade formula was raw milk, along with several other ingredients. I might do a video here in a little bit once my little girl gets here on how we make our homemade formula. So we decided to try it, and I prayed that my son would not die from the raw milk. If you Google raw milk, you will probably think that if you give it to your child, they're going to get sick immediately. And if you mention it to your pediatrician, they'll probably say the same thing. Here is a half gallon of the raw milk that we get from a local farmer. We buy this in half gallons and full gallons, and then I usually put it in a smaller mason jar so it's easier to pour. I make our milk kefir, our homemade yogurt, and just lots of other things with our raw milk. I'm gonna give a little disclaimer. I'm not a dietitian, a doctor, any of those. I just do a lot of research, and this is just my opinions on raw milk and why our family drinks it and the backstory on how it helped my son and why we will continue to drink it here in the future. I definitely encourage you, if you're interested in starting drinking raw milk, to do your own research. These are strictly my opinions. I'm not telling anyone to go drink raw milk. I'm gonna start out with just talking about the dangers of raw milk. If you Google raw milk, you're gonna think that millions of people get sick every year and die from foodborne illnesses because it's not pasteurized. There could be bacteria in it. I will have linked in the description box to the research behind drinking raw milk. One article that I have linked states that you have a 1 in 6 million chance of getting severely sick from drinking raw milk. So a lot of the statistics seem higher than they really are because such a small percentage of the population actually drinks raw milk. That basically means that the smaller the sample size, the larger the percentage is gonna look of people that are getting sick. Since so many more people in the United States drink pasteurized milk, the people that drink raw milk, the few that do get sick, it makes that percentage go up. So you kind of have to weigh the pros and cons here of the benefits of drinking raw milk to the disadvantages, and I think I'm gonna take the benefits over that 1 in 6 million chance. Our family has never had any issues with it, and we'll continue to drink it. We'll continue to make homemade formula with it when we have little ones, if they need to supplement. My son started drinking it at 4.5 months in a formula. No, we did not give him straight raw milk at 4.5 months. He never got sick. It actually helped his weight skyrocket once we got him off all that toxic formula that we had been giving him, and he has never been better. Move on now to the benefits of raw milk. You may wonder, why would we not just drink pasteurized milk like most people in America? But the reason for that is when milk is pasteurized and then shipped to grocery stores all across the United States, the pasteurization kills all of the bacteria in the milk. So it's killing the bad bacteria, but it's also killing the good bacteria. The good bacteria is what helps our body properly digest the milk, the lactose and the pathogens and the enzymes in there. Without that good bacteria, that's why so many people have issues with drinking milk and why they think they're lactose intolerant. However, many of those people that will try raw milk actually have much better time digesting raw milk than pasteurized milk, because that raw milk has those good enzymes and bacteria to help their body properly digest it and use the nutrients from that milk. So milk in its rawest, pure state is actually very easy to digest. We've never had any stomach issues. I actually drink this all through pregnancy. There's also been studies showing that the vitamins and minerals in pasteurized milk is completely wiped out. So you're missing a lot of the essential vitamins and minerals that you get from milk when you drink pasteurized milk. So just so many much more health benefits of drinking food in its raw state. Just my opinion. So much of our food and our environments are just sterilized to such an extent these days. We do this by taking antibiotics, using antibacterial soap, and pasteurizing all of our foods. That just wipes away all of the good and bad bacteria. Raw milk has not caused us any issues, and we will continue drinking it. Now I'm gonna go on to where we purchase raw milk. So this can kind of be a challenge. When I first started looking for raw milk, I was just looking online at where in the world can I find raw milk. You can't buy it at the grocery store in our state. I don't know many farmers around here. We were new to the area. So I got on the website Real Milk Finder. I'll have all this linked below. And you can search your state and it will tell you all of the farmers that are available to sell raw milk. Now in some states this is legal, some states this is not. Some states allow you to buy it from the local farm, some states allow you to buy it at the grocery store, and some states it's not even legal at all. It kind of has to be done undercover by word of mouth. That was the case in our state. So I started by looking on that website. My husband and I reached out to a couple of the farmers and just asked them if we could come tour their farms and see the environment that the cows were raised in and what they were being fed, they being given any antibiotics. And I just had a whole list of questions that I had researched online of what I wanted to ask the farmer, and I will link that list down below too for you as well. Basically, we just chatted around with a few and we're trying to find the best one for us. Several of them were about an hour's drive for us, and if I was gonna be using this raw milk weekly, I didn't really wanna be making an hour drive every week to get milk on top of my normal grocery trips. So we actually have a little community about 30 minutes away where we get a lot of our pasture chickens. Sometimes we get eggs from there, and then some lamb, and then sometimes we even get beef. And we've just developed a friendship with this farmer. My husband was like, why don't I just reach out to him and see if he knows anybody in his area that sells raw milk. And he actually did. So we reached out to his friend and was able to find out that they only just consume it in their family and then sell it to a few local friends. They don't advertise in any way. I told you in our state, it's not actually legal to sell raw milk. So it kind of has to be done by word of mouth. Little system set up where you just come in and leave the money and take your milk. So it's been very convenient. We usually stock up on about 4 or 5 whole gallons and then a couple of half gallons that we keep in the fridge. And then I just decant it into larger mason jars and freeze it. I know that sounds kind of weird to freeze milk, but we've never had any issues with it. I just thaw it in the refrigerator. Sometimes the cream will separate from the whey and you do have to mix it up. It's never been any issue. It's perfectly fine to make yogurt, milk kefir. I did that when I made my son's formula. So just by word of mouth, you can probably find someone in your area or close to your area that is willing to take on a couple of customers, a couple of families to sell raw milk. A lot of people might have a dairy cow, but in their one family, they cannot consume all of the milk that that cow is going to produce. Jersey cow will produce up to 3 to 4 gallons a day. So with all that being said, don't get discouraged if you're wanting to venture out on the raw milk journey and you're having trouble finding a local farmer, especially if you live in more of a larger city. We are kind of in a rural area and we drive to an even more rural area to get our milk. It is possible. Just keep searching. Check out the website that I'll have linked below that will kind of get you on a good start on where you can find some raw milk. I hope to have just encouraged you to think about the benefits of drinking raw milk. We've had nothing but great things to say about raw milk in our family. It completely transformed my son's health when he was a young infant, switching him to this formula. That is just our experience with raw milk, how it has helped our family, and just our opinions on it. So definitely research them for yourselves if you're interested in drinking raw milk, and don't hesitate to ask me any questions. If you enjoyed this video, if you are new to my channel, please don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. It really helps to support my channel. Thank you all so much for watching today.